Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. My name is Sarah, and today I thought I would go ahead and share a weekly makeup basket with you. Now, I have not done one of these, I think, all year so far, but I also didn't think I was gonna be participating in a lot of Project Pan projects, but since I've jumped in on a few, I decided to go ahead and share what I am using with you. I don't wanna ramble on, so let's go ahead and just jump on in, and I'm gonna show you what I'll be using for this week. Okay, so for starters, you can see I am so close to being done with this IT Cosmetics CC cream. My shade is in medium, and I'm all the way down here, I think, with just a few uses left. I usually only use this on the weekends or when I am working from home. But when I do have to go into the office, which is still a couple of days out of the week, I am using this combo here. So this is the Cover FX Blurring Primer, and this is actually, it doesn't say it anywhere on the tube, but this is a tinted primer, and I do like it with this NARS foundation because I feel like this is, it's a little bit thin, so I do like that there's a little bit of extra coverage with that primer. So this is the All Day Luminous Weightless Foundation, and my shade is in Fiji. And then no matter what, whether I'm wearing the CC cream or whether I'm wearing the actual primer and foundation combo, I am using concealer. And so the concealer that I'm working through right now is the Too Faced Born This Way Multi-Use Sculpting Concealer. And I've been using this for, I'm gonna say a little more than a month at this point, probably about, actually probably closer to 2 months. My shade is in nude. For powders, I still have two. So I am using just under my eyes to set my concealer. And then if I have like any spots where I'm using concealer on my face, I'm using the Cover FX Translucent Light Setting Powder. And this I actually really, really like. It's a really light powder. And then I'm also using, for the remainder of my face, I'm using the Becca Hydra Mist Set and Refresh Powder. So this is almost done, and then I've got another, I've got my Laura Mercier that I bought recently from my Ulta haul that's kind of waiting in the wings. For color products on my face, I have this Clinique bronzer, which you know I've tried for over a year now making progress in. This is the True Bronzer in shade 02 Sunkissed. And then I've got my blush that is bronzy as well. This is the Studio Makeup blush in the shade Sahara. Still working to get some pan on that one. And then I've got two highlighters that I use. As my cream highlight, I'm using the ColourPop Super Shock Cheek in the shade Lunch Money. So there's that one, really, really loving that one. And then for my powdered highlight, I am using Tarte Exposed. So there you go, there is that one as well. And I am going ahead and setting everything with this Milani Make It Last setting spray. This one, they call it a 16-hour wear. I wasn't getting great results from it initially, but I think that I just wasn't using enough. So now I have made sure to apply a generous mist to my face, and I have seen some better results with this one. So happier with that now. Let's move on to eyes, and then we'll do lips, and then we'll be done. So for my eyes, I'm trying to stick with concentrating on one liner and one mascara. So the liner that I'm really, really trying to get used up right now is the Urban Decay 24/7 Glide-On Pencil in the shade Perversion. So this is just the black shade. This is in Throwback 30, so I'm really trying to get, you know, like I said, get finished with that one. And then this is just a little sample of the Tarte Lights Camera Lashes. This one is getting pretty old. It was old before I started using it, and so it's drying out a little bit. So I'm only going to use this probably for another week or two. And then I forgot to mention my primer that I'm using. This is the NARS Pro Prime. They call it a smudge-proof eyeshadow base. I do like it. This is in my Finish 20 for the year. I do like this. It is nice and silky, but I don't really feel like it's that revolutionary. I don't feel like it's that much different than a lot of the other eyeshadow bases that I've used. And then I'm also using on my eyes this Thrive Cosmetics. It's called the Brilliant Eye Brightener, and it is in the shade Stella. This is a really nice champagne colored, basically a, you know, a what do you call these? Eyeshadow crayon, I guess, is what you would call it. All right, finishing up the eyes, I've got two palettes that I'm working on. Obviously, I'm still working on my Pan That palette for the year. This is the Pure Cosmetics Soiree Diaries. This is a super nude palette. I do have an update that I've already filmed that I will be posting hopefully in the next couple of days if I can get that edited. And then I also am using the ColourPop Element of Surprise kind of as my complement palette. This one is very the opposite of neutral. This one has a ton of really bold colors in it. So I am using that to complement my Pan That palette for the year. And then, like I said, finishing up with lips, I've got a lip scrub that I've been using quite a bit recently. This is the Sugar and Lemon Moisturizing Lip Buffer by Seraphine Botanicals. Sugar and lemon, two of my favorite things, so really, really enjoying that. And then I'm using a ton of lip balm lately. This one is the Spa doTERRA lip balm in the tropical scent or tropical flavor. It's not a super strong flavor, so I do really like that. It's not really sticky either, so that one's very nice. I am focusing on just this one lipstick for the week. This is the NARS lip pencil in the shade Rakugian. I'm really, really trying to get that one finished up, guys. So hopefully this will not be sticking around for very much longer. And then just to top it off for something different and something a little casual, this is the Milani Lip. I always forget what this is called. Keep It Full Nourishing Lip Plumper. And this is in the shade Rosy Bronze. Love this one as well. It's a great, it is a little bit plumping. It's not, you know, super, super tingly or anything like that. And it is just a nice subtle shade. So really enjoy that one as well. So guys, that's everything I have to share with you. Oh no, it's not. Hold on. I also am focusing on a fragrance for this week as well. So this is the At the Beach Fine Fragrance Mist from Bath & Body Works. This is also in my Finish 20 for the year, and I'm doing okay. I forget a lot of times because I'm not accustomed to wearing fragrance anymore, but I am trying to work on this. There's obviously not that much left, so I am just trying to move that one out. So that's why I've put it in my basket to really focus on for this week. So now that is everything I have to share with you guys. Thanks so much for joining me. If you are working on a weekly makeup basket, drop a comment down below and let me know. I'd love to check out your video. Also, let me know how often you want to see these. At one point I did them weekly, and then at one point I did them every other week. And like I said, I haven't done any of these for the year. So this is, you know, I'm just starting to get back into it. So let me know how often you want to see these, and I will talk to you all really soon. Bye.